Today, I'm going to explain a small topic that's about service attributes, which is used while evaluating of alternative services. The people who took marketing as their specialization subject already knows the process involved in a purchase decision. That is, the first step will be need awareness, and then information search, and then evaluation of alternatives, and finally purchasing decision. But here we are considering about services, not products, okay? When we talk about service consumption, there is actually a three-stage model of service consumption. The three stages are pre-purchase, service encounter, and post-encounter stages. Here, the pre-purchase stage, it includes need awareness, information search, evaluation of alternatives, and making a purchase decision. During the second stage, that is service encounter stage, the customer initiates, experiences, and consumes the service. The post-encounter stage includes evaluation of the service performance, which determines the future intentions, that is, if there is any repurchase intentions. And of course, it also determines PWOM, that is a positive word of mouth, that is their recommendation intention. Okay. So in the pre-purchase stage, the third step is evaluation of alternative services. Here we will use a multi-attribute model to understand how consumers evaluate and choose between alternative service offerings. So you must have awareness about what service attributes means. That is multi-attribute model. That model assumes that the consumers can evaluate all important attributes before purchase. Some attributes may be harder to evaluate and some may be easy to evaluate. Okay, there are three types of attributes. They are search attributes, experience attributes, and credence attributes. Okay, what you mean by search attributes? They are tangible characteristics. Tangible means we can see, we can touch, we can smell. Okay, so tangible characteristics that consumers can evaluate before purchase. For example, search attributes for a restaurant include type of food, location, and price. These things we can check before purchase, okay? For another instance, if you want to use the services of a health club, you can take a tour of a health club and try working out with one or two pieces of the gym equipment. So these tangible search attributes helps customers better understand and evaluate a service, therefore reducing a sense of uncertainty or risk associated with the purchase. Goods such as automobiles, clothing, furniture, jewelry are high in search qualities because their attributes can be almost completely determined and evaluated before purchase. Next we call is experience attributes. They cannot be evaluated before purchase. That is, the customer must experience the service. That is, in a restaurant, you won't know how much you actually like the food. Similarly, the service provided by your waiter and the atmosphere or ambience in the restaurant until you are actually using the service. So the experience qualities are the attributes that we knew only after purchase or during consumption. Okay. So goods and services such as vacations and restaurant meals are high in experience qualities because their attributes cannot be known or assessed until they have been purchased and are being consumed. For example, if we want to know about a specific holiday destination, people can scroll through websites describing specific holiday destination, view travel films, read reviews by travel experts and past guests, or hear about the experiences from families and friends. They cannot really evaluate or feel the dramatic beauty associated with, say, for example, hiking in the Himalayas. So until they actually experience that service, they don't get the dramatic beauty associated with it. Okay. So that's about experience attributes. Third category is credence attributes. These are the characteristics that customers find hard to evaluate even after consumption. That is, the characteristics that consumer may find impossible to evaluate even after purchase and consumption. For example, you can imagine about a surgery. That is, few consumers possess medical skills which is sufficient to evaluate whether these services are necessary or are performed properly even after they have been prescribed and produced by the seller. So here the customer is forced to believe or trust that certain tasks have been performed at the promised level of quality. If we take the restaurant example, credence attributes will be there. It include the hygiene conditions in the kitchen, the nutritional quality and the freshness of ingredients used. Okay, let's say we actually don't know, do they really use the higher grade of olive oil for cooking? Similarly, it's not easy for a customer to determine the quality of repair and maintenance work performed on a car. And patients can't usually evaluate how well their dentists have performed complex dental procedures. Also, you can consider about professional services like counseling, surgery, legal advice and consulting services. How can you really be sure that the best possible job was done? So it's a matter of having confidence in the provider's skills and professionalism. That's about credence attributes. So all products can be placed on a continuum ranging from easy to evaluate to difficult to evaluate. That's depending on whether they are high in search, experience or credence attributes. So we can observe most physical goods are located somewhere towards the left of the continuum because they rank high in search attributes, and most services tend to be located from the center to the right of the continuum as they tend to be high in experience and credence attributes. The harder is to evaluate a service, the higher is the perceived risk associated with that decision. Okay. So that's about search versus experience versus credence properties of services. Hope you got some idea about this concept. Thank you for watching and see you in another video.